Hey guys, welcome to Photoshop Pro Help. Now today I'm going to be teaching this awesome circle pixel effect. Now this effect is really dead simple and easy, and it only takes a few steps to create this stunning piece of artwork. Now first things first is you're going to need to load your image into Photoshop. You can have any image you want, it doesn't matter how small or how pixelated the said image is. So I'm just going to go over to the image we're going to be working on. Now this is a low resolution image, but it doesn't matter. You can even have a really high definition image and it'll work just as well as the low definition. So from here, once we have loaded our image into Photoshop, we're going to go up to filter and we're going to go over to pixelate and then mosaic. From here you can notch up the cell size to whatever you want, depending on how much detail you want to come through. Now whatever cell size you pick, you need to remember it. So I'm going to go for a cell size of 9 squares here. That would work fine for this image. You will need to experiment to see what kind works best with your image. So click OK. From here we're going to go up to File and New. We're making a new blank document. Now the cell size that I said for you to remember, this is how it's going to come into play. We're going to have width 9 pixels and height 9 pixels. So if you set your cell size to 35, you're going to change the width to 35 and the height to 35, whatever you've changed your cell size to be. So mine is 9, so I'm going to keep that the same. Click OK. Now this is really small, so I'm going to zoom in. And from here, I'm just going to go and hide this layer. So double click the background layer to unlock it, and then we're just pressing the eye on the right hand side to hide it. Make a new blank layer on the bottom right hand side, and we're going to go up to the left hand side at the top. Just go to the elliptical marquee tool and we're just going to hold down shift on our keyboard, and just from the top left hand side, just on the inside, just scroll outwards. This makes a perfect circle, so it's the size of this square. Now we're going to go up to select inverse, and that selects the outside of the circle, and we're just going to go to our paint bucket tool, make sure we've got white selected as our foreground color, and click inside. Now once you have done that, we're going to press Control and D to deselect. From here all we're going to do now is go up to edit. We're going to go up to down to define pattern, and you can name your pattern whatever you want. So I'm just going to call mine dot, but I've already made mine so I don't need to press OK. You will do though. And just going to go back to our image that we're working on. From here we're going to make a new blank layer, so bottom right hand side again, new blank layer icon, and we're just going to fill this with whatever color that we want. So paint bucket tool on the left hand side, I have gone for white, so click that. And then all from here we're just going to double click the layer that we're working on, and you've got the layer styles come up. So all we're going to change from here is the fill opacity is set to 100%. We're just going to go and notch that down to 0. As you can see, it's brung back the image. And all we're going to do now is go down to pattern overlay, click on the pattern drop down menu, and your circle should be right at the bottom. Click that and then click OK, and there you have it. You have a stunning bit of artwork. You can really play around with this. I will say, play around with the circle on how big your circles are, because you can really change the effect up. So it doesn't have to be down to these small little images. You can change it to these big high definition images, picture of a duck, depending on whatever cell size you go for. That defines how much stuff is going to come through on the image. So this duck here is not too bad. I would notch this down so you can see more detail. So play around with this and really put your own stamp on things. Please comment, rate and subscribe, and go check out the website, and I'll see you next time guys. Bye for now.